It was third time's a charm for a Mediterranean with Greek Isles cruise. This was our first stay in Rome because it was the year of lost luggage. It was wait 4 hours here and pick up our luggage or wait 2 days so they can deliver our luggage. So we spent actually a total of almost 7 hours in this area. Finally arrived at our hotel, the Nazionale in Rome. Perfect location. The customer service was excellent. Everything was really close by. Everything was walking distance and the rooms were very nice. This is the view right outside the hotel. Everything is very nice and neat, and everything is really close by. After dropping off our bags and grabbing a quick bite, we walked around the city looking at everything that was nearby, the Pantheon, and grabbed a gelato to end the day. Day two started with coffee and a quick pastry to start the day. Again, we walked around the area, looking at all the beautiful sights. Found a beautiful little church in an alleyway. Also walked to the Trevi Fountain. Made our way to the Spanish Steps. Lunchtime, took a taxi to Trastevere. The Free Now app is basically the quickest way to grab a taxi. Even though taxis were open at the time, they won't stop unless they were called through the app. We had lunch at Da Enzo. It's featured in a lot of YouTube videos, so we tried it, and there's a reason why the line is out the door. The food was incredible. This was the best food. In the afternoon, we did the excavation tour underneath the Vatican. It is an incredible tour. You need to either email the Vatican to get tickets directly from them, or there are tour groups who actually do it, but they charge you 3 times the price. After the tour, which we couldn't take any pictures, we looked around the regular part of St. Peter's. Dinner that night was at a nearby restaurant near our hotel. Day three was at a different cafe with coffees and pastry. We booked a tour of the Colosseum through Get Your Guide. It says access to the Gladiator Arena, but you actually do not get to go down to the Gladiator Arena. You just get to look down at it. So that was kind of disappointing. We had the great luck of being there during a taxi strike. So we walked to the restaurant Osteria da Fortuna before heading back to our hotel. Less than 5 minutes away, it's Piazza Navona near our hotel. We ended the day at 2 sizes. Very good tiramisu. Finally, embarkation day, first day of the cruise. The waiting area where you find out if you've trusted clear to board. First stop, lunch at Rapunzel's Royal Table. our room, deluxe inside stateroom. Our first dinner rotation was at Animator's Palette. Second day of the cruise was Palermo, Italy. We didn't find any excursions that were very interesting, so we walked around and just had a little gelato. Mostly did shopping on this day. On our way back, we saw the little train. Wish we would have had time to do that. We got reservations this night for Paolo dinner. We ended the evening watching the ventriloquist comedian. Day three was at sea. We booked the mojito and caipirinha tasting.
My name is Glenis. I am all the way from the Dominican Republic. Dominican Republic is one of the most beautiful islands in Caribbean after Castaway Key, all right? Okay, I need to say my...
That afternoon, we came upon a ship. They had to make sure that everyone was okay before we moved on. Dinner was at Lumiere's. Santorini, Greece. You will be tendering here, and you will need to take a cable car to the main area. We booked an excursion through excursions.com. It was intimate Santorini. It was about 4 hours long. You are taken to Ia, where you will have time to explore on your own. Our tour guide took us to a winery where we had little snacks and tasted some wine. He also took us to the top spot of Santorini, then concluded by dropping us off in Fira, where we had time to explore on our own. After some shopping, took the cable car back down to the ship. Dinner was at Animator's Palette. Day 5, Mykonos, Greece. We did the Disney excursion Mykonos Highlights and Anomera Monastery. We were given snacks and water before going into the monastery. Very small monastery, but very detailed and beautiful inside. We made a brief stop at a beach resort for bathroom break. Our final stop was the old port of Mykonos. This is where all the beautiful little alleyways are and the windmills. This is a place that I wish we would spend all our time. We informed our guide we would be doing the rest on our own. We had a nice long lunch, then explored the area on our own. When we were done, we simply took the free shuttles that are provided by Disney. Dinner was at Rapunzel's.